Hi all, today we have a very very special recipe by a special person. It's ragi khali and pirandai chutney. You can just translate and find it. I just don't want to spoil the beauty of the recipe by translating it in English. So we are taking around 1/2 kg of ragi flour and sieving it really nicely. This is made by a special person. She is Maheshwari. She helps us out with the home chores in our house. We have to take around 1.5 liter of water for the 1/2 kg of flour. And I have to really thank her. Mageshreka, romba 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 thank you. Skate odne othukittinga, aduve periya vishayam. Thank you so much. So 1.5 liter of water, let it boil. And we have to make the chutney. You can see all the displayed items are needed for the chutney. Pirandai is one of the medicinal plants. If you can find a hold of this plant, make sure you get it and make this chutney, okay? It's really good for your health, good for your guts. So let's make the chutney first. You can see once more onion, green chili, coconut, tamarind and the pirandai leaves. So this is the weapon she's going to use to make it because it is little hard work. So first let's make the chutney. Pour in little oil. If it's groundnut oil, it's the best, as she told. She's putting in the onions inside. We'll have to saute it for a few minutes because the pirandai, basically the main star ingredient of the chutney, will take a little long to get sauteed. So we are starting the chutney process. It's basically just sauteing it until it's done. So now it's time to add the pirandai. It's washed and chopped. You really don't have to chop it because you're basically going to grind it. So I'll just show you the plant in one of my vlogs. We have a little plant at home. So the water has been boiled. She brought it down to the floor and she put all the ragi flour into it. And the process seems very simple. It's basically adding the flour into the boiled water and mixing it. But you will see how tough it is. She has a little bowl of water and little more hot water. So that if it becomes a shortage, you can add hot water whenever you need it. You have to sit down like this. Traditionally, she's making it very traditionally, so don't take it in any other means. It's done like this, okay? That's how people made it when in olden days. So she just made it like that. I requested her to make it in a very very traditional form, so she's making it for me. A big thank you to her because she is very busy person. She has lots of work to do, but she when I requested, she told yes. Kandipa paneer lampa, that was her reply, which is really tough to find these days. Look at that mixing. I literally tried to recreate it or something. It's very difficult, people. It does not look very tough, but it's actually tough. It's very hot. You might think it's really really cold and she's touching the pot and things like that. No, it's burning hot. But she is used to it and she makes it for everybody. My dad loves this recipe, so whenever she makes at home, she makes sure she packs for my dad and for my uncle. And there's a lot of people in her association who loves this recipe. We normally tell her to make a shop making. She knows lots of traditional recipes which people are running into right now in this lockdown period, and she has promised me to make many other medicinal plants chutneys. So the one after the other, I'll be planting the medicinal plants, and also she'll be making chutneys out of it. So wait and watch. We have our Maheshwari in hand for making all the chutneys and stuff. She'll teach us, and it's really good for our health and good for our kids. So what is the best thing? When somebody says good for your kid, you're going to do it. I have already done it. I've planted a pirandai plant in my backyard. She gave me that little bit of it to be planted, and I've already planted it. It is actually growing. I'll just show you in one of my vlogs. So mix it up. Keep mixing. Once the water boiled, she just put in all that ragi flour and she started mixing. I would tell she has hardly mixed it for around 5 minutes, and then she has to put it back in the stove. Can you see that steam coming out? Oh my god. And she was touching it. I was just telling her you can do it later, but no, you have to do it when it's hot. That is the specialty of this recipe. If you do it little later and all, it will have that little lumps in it and it will not be smooth balls. So she's adding little water and pushing it down and cooking it again. Now she'll take this to the stove and she'll be cooking it. You can see she's adding hot water. Okay, keep in hand one and a half tumbler of hot water by side. The pirandai is all done. She's adding curry leaves and the green chili, I think. Yeah, green chilies will also be going into it, and she'll be sauteing it for a few more minutes. This is a little, hot वेरी वेरी हॉट चटनी बिकॉज द बेसिकली रागी कली इज टेस्टलेस अकॉर्डिंग टू मी बट आई शुड नॉट से दैट इट्स वेरी हेल्दी रेसिपी कैन यू सी इट्स कुकिंग इन द स्टोव इट्स इन द हाई एक्चुअली एंड शी टोल्ड मी यू हैव टू कुक इट बाई स्टरिंग इट अगेन एंड अगेन लाइक दिस दिस इज बेसिकली सेकेंड टाइम इन द स्टोव फर्स्ट द वाटर वॉज बॉयलिंग देन शी टुक इट डाउन एंड शी ब्रॉट इट बैक सो सेकेंड टाइम द नाउ यू हैव टू कुक द फ्लावर That's what she's doing it. It's a little tough work, but you can try it out with one glass of flour or something. That's what I'm going to do. And if you're a Malayali at home, you'll definitely have that kind of wooden thing which you'll use for patiri and nulputtu. I think so that will also work. Basically, you need wooden flat spoons or something so that you can just move into the flour and mix it without forming any lumps. So let that cook, put it in medium and add little more hot water according to the consistency. The dough has to come out like balls. When you touch it, you will not be able to have anything into your hands. It should not be basically sticky and that's the, I think so that is how it should be. Yeah, that's how she told me. When you touch the hot mess, you will not be able to get anything in your hands. It should be like non-sticky. She'll be showing it in the later stage of the video. Now she's mixing it, letting it be for 5 minutes. This procedure went on for 10-15 minutes. So by the time the chutney thing is done, we are going to add it into the mixer. To the mixer, add in first the coconut and the tamarind. That's what she's saying, like, Papa, idha modalla potrunga, adukapram dhaan idha podrom. That's what she told. So my mom is helping her out because making the ragi curry itself is a biggest procedure since we were watching it. But don't worry, you can definitely make it with a little amount. We're adding little salt. And again she's mixing. Mix it up. Again she's mixing it. So seeing it, don't get terrified. She's making a huge amount and that's why it feels like this is not going to get over. It's not like that. See, she's touching it and nothing is sticking to her hands. That is the time when it's done. It took around 15 minutes and 3 to 4 times of stirring it in medium flame. That is how much time it took on stove. She is offing it. Now it's ready. We are going to take it down again and to her position. That's a towel so that her leg does not get burnt out of it. Again, you're going to mix it really well. This mixing should be very, very fast. Can you see that? She is making it very, very fast. I have not speeded up the video. She is making it that faster. And she was just teaching me like horizontally and go around and round. All that procedures what her mother taught her and she has been carrying it over to her kids also. Now it's time to roll it out. Look, she'll take a lump and she'll roll it in the hands with water. And make some clean, clean, clean ball. And that's how it is eaten. You take one ball, add the chutney to that ball and eat it. If you want, you can add salt also to it. But if you have a really good curry or a chutney with so much of salt and heat to it, you really don't have to add salt to this. So this procedure is really tough, okay? It's like piping hot. Make water in your hands and make sure you don't burn yourself. And if you want, you can add gloves if you cannot do this procedure by hands. She is experienced and that's why she's doing it. So we got around 6 balls from half kg of flour. We shared it with neighbors and friends and we had a really good time having this healthy and nutritious ragi kali. Thank you to her because it's like nobody will do that without anything, without expecting anything. She is a person who does everything without expecting anything, just like every mother. So it's time to make the chutney. It is like a cool down. So we're making the chutney. Look at that. The chutney was an excellent hit in our house. Though ragi kali is not something which everybody will like, but the chutney was a huge hit. Even the kids had it. Though it was so, so hot and spicy, the kids never bothered about it because the chutney was so tasty. We are going to redo the chutney again. Can you see the chutney is also ready? The kali is also ready. My dad is in heaven. Whenever he gets this or he knows it's there, he is the happiest person in the world. He normally rewinds back to his olden days when he got only this to eat. Because normally, olden days, there's no rice, only ragi and other millets were there. So we enjoyed. So hope you also enjoyed.